Hello student, welcome to my channel. Today we learn a new chapter, deflection of beam under strength of materials. This is a simply supported beam supported at this end and this end. This is the front view. This is the original neutral line. Load applied at midpoint. After application of load, this is the deformed neutral line. This is the deformed neutral line after application of load. Figure shows the beam with a vertical load and the deformed neutral line. This is the neutral line after application of load. This is the deformed neutral line. This is simple supported beam. Both end are supported. This is the vertical displacement. This is vertical displacement. Here the vertical displacement is maximum. At end point, vertical displacement 0. This is the vertical displacement at that point. At that point, this is vertical displacement. This is vertical displacement. This is vertical displacement. At midpoint, maximum vertical displacement. This deformed neutral line is called elastic curve. This curve is called elastic curve. This is the neutral line. AB is simple supported beam. AB is neutral line supported at A and B. At a distance x at point C or at section C, deflection is delta. Deflection is delta. Angle of slope. Angle of slope means at point C, if we draw a tangent, this is a tangent and this is the horizontal line. At point C, this is a tangent and this is the horizontal line. This angle is called angle of slope theta. At point C, deflection is delta. At point C, angle of slope is theta. Figures shows slope theta and deflection delta at any section C. Now we define what is deflection. Deflection delta. Deflection at any section of a beam is the vertical displacement of the neutral layer or neutral line of the beam at that section due to bending. Okay, at C section, this is vertical displacement, this is called deflection at C. At A point, deflection 0, at B point, deflection 0. So deflection at any section of a beam is the vertical displacement of the neutral layer of the beam at that section due to bending. Okay, when beam is loaded, the neutral layer would bend into a curve. This curve is called elastic curve for the loaded beam. This curve is called elastic curve. This curve is called elastic curve. Deformed neutral line or deformed neutral layer is called elastic curve. Okay. Now, what is slope or angle of slope theta? Slope at any point in the bent form of a beam is the tangent of the angle made with the horizontal by the tangent drawn at that point to the curve, so generated due to the bending of the beam. So angle of slope is the at point C, draw a tangent at point C, and this at point C, this is the horizontal line. This angle called angle of slope. Angle of slope for simple supported beam with point load, angle of slope at point A, this is maximum angle of slope at point A. If we draw a tangent, angle of slope is maximum at middle point. If we draw a tangent, angle of slope is zero. Okay, cantilever beam with point load. This is a cantilever beam, one end fixed, other end phi. At phi end, W point load applied. Length of the beam is L. At this end, deflection is maximum. This is delta max. If we draw a tangent at end, this is the tangent, this is the maximum angle of slope theta max. Okay, at this end, theta max is zero. At this end, theta is maximum. Okay, delta also maximum, delta means deflection, theta means slope, angle of slope. Okay. Now, cantilever beam with UDL, uniformly distributed load. This is a cantilever beam. This end is fixed. This cantilever beam applied a UDL value is omega per unit length. At this end, deflection is maximum. Deflection delta is maximum, delta max. Delta max is maximum at this end. If we draw a tangent, this is angle of slope. At this end, angle of slope is maximum. This is theta max, angle of slope at this end, maximum. Okay. Simply supported beam with point load. This is a simple supported beam supported at this end and this end. At midpoint, a point load W is applied. This length is L by 2. This length is L by 2. Deflection is maximum at midpoint. Delta max. This is maximum deflection. Deflection at end, this is zero. Deflection, this is at that point, this is the deflection, this is the deflection. At that point, this is the deflection, this is the deflection. At midpoint, this is the maximum deflection. Angle of slope at this end and this end is maximum. At this point, we draw a tangent. This is the tangent. Theta is the angle of slope. This is maximum. At this point also, this is maximum. Angle of slope is maximum. Angle of slope at midpoint, if we draw a tangent, angle of slope is zero for simply supported beam. Okay. This is a simply supported beam with UDL. This is UDL load. W equal to capital W equal to omega into L. Capital W equal to omega into L. This is applied at midpoint. Okay. This is not point load. Capital W equal to omega into L. This is maximum deflection. This is maximum angle of slope at this point. This is maximum angle of slope at this point. This is maximum angle of slope at midpoint. Angle of slope is zero. Okay. Now we carefully remember this table. Types of beam, maximum deflection, maximum angle of slope, maximum bending moment. This is cantilever with point load. Next, cantilever with UDL. Next, simply supported with point load. Next, simply supported with UDL. Delta max for cantilever with point load, delta max for cantilever with UDL, delta max for simply supported with point load, delta max for simply supported with UDL. First, we remember this numerical part. This is 1/3, this is 1/8, this is 1/48, this is 5/384. Remaining portion is same, WLQ by EI. Cantilever with point load, maximum deflection 1/3 WLQ by EI. Cantilever with UDL 1/8 WLQ by EI. Simply supported with point load 1/48 WLQ by EI. Simply supported with UDL 5/384 WLQ by EI. This part is same, only we remember this numerical part 1/3, 1/8, 1/48, 5/384. E is the Young modulus of the materials of the beam. I equal to moment of inertia of that section of the beam about its neutral axis. MI about its neutral axis. Section may be I section, may be T section, any section. L is the length of the beam. Capital W, load applied on the beam. Omega for UDL, omega equal to weight per unit length. Total load W equal to omega into L for UDL. Okay. Now, maximum angle of slope for cantilever with point load. Maximum angle of slope for cantilever with UDL. Maximum angle of slope simply supported with point load. Maximum angle of slope simply supported with UDL. We only remember this numeric part 1/2, 1/6, 1/16, 1/28. Other part are same, WL square by EI, WL square by EI, WL square by EI, WL square by EI. For UDL, this W equal to omega into L. For UDL, this W equal to omega into L. So, cantilever with point load, maximum angle of slope 1/2 WL square by EI. Cantilever with UDL, maximum deflection 1 by 6 W L square by EI, simply supported with point load, maximum deflection is 1 by 16 W L square by EI, simply supported with UDL, maximum deflection is 1 by 24 W L square by EI. Now maximum bending moment. We only remember the numeric part 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 8. Remaining part WL, 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 WL are same. Only we remember 1, half, 1 by 4, 1 by 8. Maximum bending moment for cantilever with point load W into L, capital W into L. Maximum bending moment for cantilever with UDL, W, capital W L by 2, here capital W equal to omega into L. Maximum bending moment for simply supported with point load, capital W L by 4. Simply supported with UDL, maximum bending moment W L by 8. Here capital W equal to omega into L. Omega is the weight per unit length of the beam. Okay, clear my student? Thank you.